Hello, Billings Central Music Department. I wanted to take you through a quick walkthrough of everything we're going to be doing this year to stay safe, but have fun. When you first come in, we're going to enter now through the art hallway, and we're going to go to the hand washing station. When we first come in, we'll sanitize. Proper sanitation keeps us safe and healthy. In the fingers, nails, and we're good to go. The biggest thing we're gonna make sure we're doing is not congregating in our groups. When we're done washing our hands, we're gonna get in our own pod and be ready to participate with our instrument or singing. In your pod, you have extra sanitizer, which is safe for instruments, mouthpieces, and reeds as well. Your music stand, which is your first line of defense against flying spit particles. Then you have your chair. All three things are your responsibility to sanitize at the end of the bell, and there is disinfecting wipes throughout the room. So, you hear the bell, you grab a wipe, and you clean your area. That easy. Along with your pod area, it is 6 foot circumference. Most classrooms are 6 foot side to side or front to back. I wanted to do a complete 6 foot circumference. Except for my trombone players, they have to be 9 feet. So, you guys get your own room. In all my current research, the biggest thing that music has been talking about is airflow, airflow, airflow. We got a HEPA filter that is capable of filtering 5,000 square feet. This room is about 1,900 square feet, so this little guy should do just a fine job. It also is equipped with UV lights, which is great for people with allergies like me. Filters out fungus and other bacteria and dander and pollen. So with more precautions, choir members will be singing with humanity shields and their face masks. I like to be extra safe and take multiple precautions. Band members will have instrument covers. Band member face masks will be required as well. They must have a slit or a flap, and I'm explaining those in class. So in current research at the University of Colorado in Boulder, they did an aerosol study of instruments and how far aerosol flows out of bells. Most instruments did not travel 6 feet. And as you can see by the graph, all instruments had a significant difference when they wore a bell cover. Trombones were the only instrument that traveled farther than 6 feet. They traveled up to 8 feet, almost 9 feet. So trombone players, you'll have a special spot in the band room. The bell covers are your responsibility, but if you lose it, don't worry. I made plenty extra. This is not MERV material, it just goes over the top. You take your rubber band, and voila, bell covers. If you don't have a slitted mask, that's okay too. But the most important part is musicians always cover their nose. Rehearsals this year will be in 30-minute block segments. More research is being done on airflow and air changes is what they call them. So rehearsals will be 30 minutes, then we will be taking an air change, which involves us going out of the room, going outside, and getting an air change for ourselves, but that gives enough time for the room to complete air cycle through. So every night we'll be using a Clorox 360 fog machine to be fogging everyone's pod. So along with all the precautions we're taking of cleanliness, wiping down our own things, I'm taking it a step further and I'll be fogging the entire room. percussionist. You need to have your own sticks. So we are not sharing things. If we do need to share something, glove up and sanitize afterwards. We will also not be sharing music or folders. Everything will be electronic on Schoology. So check out the Schoology page for updates and music. Unfortunately, this year, the locker rooms are gonna be off limits because it's too small of a space for 50 of us to congregate in. Instrument storage this year will be in the old choir room with 6-foot distancing to store your instruments. There'll be an overflow room on either stairwell and in the driver's ed room. Spit valves. I've always thought they were gross, so don't empty them on the floor. Instead, walk over to the hand washing station. Grab some paper towel and empty your spit valve in your paper towel. No drip, no mess. Throw your paper towel away and sanitize on your way back to your chair. Oh, hey there. All you flute players and reed players, as well as a bell cover, another safety equipment that I'd recommend you purchasing is a cover bag. And you can find those on the internet. They're pretty cool. They slip over your entire instrument and have slots for your hands. They come in white or black. You may be wondering why I'm washing my hands again. Great question. Musicians actually carry a higher chance of transmitting COVID-19. There's a lot of factors that go into that. One of the reasons we have a higher transmission rate is because of the proximity in what we are usually playing in. Another one is because we expel a lot of aerosols by either playing or singing really loud. Be patient with me. I'm putting all your music on Schoology. I hope that we have a really fun year and good year. I know there might be some fear, but that's why I'm taking so many precautions. No matter what happens this year, I'm happy to be back and creating music with all of you, and I'm counting every day as a blessing that we get to make music together. And as Rammy would say, go Rams.